the exact number of abortions, because many are performed illegally, especially in places like India. And many women started using the, I guess it's called the morning after pill, Postinor, which has been available globally for the last 4 or 5 years. So we really have no record of how many of those abortions have happened. Our speaker, Dr. Michael Swidell, was educated in Europe and immigrated to the United States in 1978. He practiced for 2 years as an obstetrics gynecology in Poznan, Poland. He did his postgraduate studies at the Medical College of Georgia in Augusta, Georgia, and the University of South Carolina in Charleston. From 1985 to 1988, he was a postdoctoral fellow at the Department of Cardiology, University of Alabama in Birmingham, studying high risk factors related to coronary artery disease. In 1988, he was appointed as a senior scientist at the Joint Center for Radiation Therapy at Harvard Medical School in Boston, where he was conducting research to develop novel methods in the treatment of cancer. From 2012 to 2015, he was an adjunct professor at the Department of Physics and Applied Physics, University of Massachusetts, Lowell. He is an author and co-author of over 25 publications and books related to cell biology, immunology, and cancer. He's done an awful lot. He is married to a registered nurse and has 3 children. In fact, one of them we're fortunate to have with us tonight, his son Alex. And Dr. Swidell and his wife Myron have never, they've always refused to perform or even assist in any abortion procedures. Please welcome Dr. Michael Swidell.
Declining trend in Europe. probably this is regarding the one day pill, which is on market now over 50 years in Europe. So that's maybe good news, but it's very difficult to pinpoint the exact numbers of abortions or abortions done at the private clinics. For example, I give you an example. Most countries are legalized abortion in Europe, except few. Malta is only one small country, Andorra, Liechtenstein, and Poland, who did not legalize abortion. Why? Because, for example, Poland was a leader under communistic regime to perform abortions, and many women coming from Sweden, Germany, to have abortions in communistic Poland because it was legal and was very cheap. You could have abortion for $20. Right now, Germany are performing with Austria 1,000 abortions a day. 1,000 abortions a day. Poland only performed 1,000 abortions in last year because for medical reasons. As I said, it's illegal, but has some kind of exceptions that the life of women is in immediate danger. Abortion has to be performed. Or this situation that fetus is absolutely has no brain, for example. That under strict rules and regulations in Poland, abortion is performed. So only 1,000 medical abortions being performed in Poland. However, the government suspects that about 50,000 Polish women have abortions in Germany and Sweden, Scandinavia, and surrounding countries, because now you can freely travel everywhere. What's very interesting is that Spain, Portugal, all these Italy, all these bastions of religion, Catholic religion, legalize abortion. The worst is, which is surprising me also, is Great Britain, where you can perform abortion at 24 weeks of pregnancy. Second champion is Netherlands. The Netherlands. You can perform abortion at 18 weeks of gestation. Norway is also in Sweden, Denmark, Berlin on the law. So theoretically, if a woman likes to have abortion, she can. Very interesting is Russia. Russia was a champion in abortions in the under Stalin and post-Stalin era. They performed millions of abortions. And right now, they have a tremendous problem with the newborn babies because it's very hardship in Russia. So President Biden a few years ago introduced legislation which will cap abortion and encourage women to have babies with financial initiatives. So Russia performed only 1.2 million abortions 2 years ago. The country is about 140 million people. I don't want to go into details about country by country in Europe, but in general, Europe is performing 4.3 million abortions a year, performed about 2 years ago. These figures are coming from WHO. But please understand that these are official abortions performed in the registered clinics. And many abortions are performed also on the table, especially in Russia and some countries, poorer countries in Europe. However, these figures are going down. Probably because which now is available everywhere. 2 weeks ago, I didn't believe my eyes. Because the one-day pill is illegal in Poland, the Dutch company called Pro Woman Choice shipped by drone from Germany across the border the one-day pills for some women in Poland. Somebody was able to record it on the YouTube. It's unbelievable what people try to do. a few minutes after, but I'd like to discuss now a little bit religion by religion, because if you look on the world map, you can see that in the world map, some countries have very little emotions, some countries don't. And so what's very interesting is to understand us, especially Catholics, what other religions are doing and talking about. So for example, Buddhists. How Buddhists are approaching emotion? Are two kinds of Buddhists, two groups, northern Buddhists, which are coming from Dalai Lama. They are mainly located in China, in Tibet, but after 1950 they have to escape to India. What's very interesting is that before 1950, northern Buddhists, people didn't know what abortion means. They didn't have any abortions. It was just miscarriages, of course, as usual, happened everywhere. But they never had abortion. It was unknown procedure, unknown. It was illegal. People didn't even understand what abortion is. But after migration to India, the northern Buddhists became influenced by Indian law. Hinduism. And I would just like to cite what Dalai Lama said on abortion. Of course, abortion, from the Buddhist viewpoint, is an act of killing and is negative, generally speaking, but it depends on the circumstances. And here is open discussion. Can they perform abortion? Yes, under certain circumstances, like life, rape, incest, they are performing abortion. Southern Buddhists, countries which are located in the southern part of Asia, like Thailand, Burma, Japan, they have very lean abortion and very open abortion. Germany, it's very easy to perform abortion in Thailand. Girl is under age 14, for example, for economical reasons, for health reasons. Japan is restricting abortions as much as they can, and they set up a very smart way to do it. If you like to have abortion, you have to pay for it, a lot of money, by the way. So abortions are very unpopular in Japan. Burma is a good example. 99% of Burmese women reject abortion. For a religion belief, they reject. So abortion is really unknown and not practiced in Burma. What's very interesting is, as I like to say, Buddhists saying that abortion is illegal, it should be not done. But as I said again, they change a little bit when time goes by. What's very interesting is Hinduism. They believe, which is true with us Christians, that soul enters the womb at the time of conception. And this makes the fetus a living individual person. Therefore, Hinduism is against abortion. However, in practice, abortion is in Hindu culture because of sometimes the situation is forcing them to do it for medical reasons. But very interesting, Hindu people prefer to have sons, not daughters. So they aborted daughters all the time. As I said, they are against abortion in general. India performed about last year or 2 years ago 6.2 million abortions. And please remember, they are almost a billion people. What is not very good, you still can perform abortion up to 20 weeks of pregnancy, which is quite high. Very dangerous situation in India is that they perform illegal abortions. All over the countrysides. But the good news is that Hinduism is, like us, believes that soul of the baby is created during conception. So it's really close to our beliefs. Muslim is also very interesting. And I've been in Saudi Arabia, the bastion of Muslim. I've been in Turkey. I've been not in Syria, but I've been very many times in Turkey. And Muslims believe that it's illegal to perform abortion, even in any kind of pregnancy, but especially after the 120 days, after 4 months, it's illegal. They believe that first 4 months, the baby is not a human, is an object in mother's womb. Therefore, it is not subject to any religious beliefs. But after 120 days, after 4 months, the baby is getting soul. So performing abortion after 120 days is a murder, considered as a murder. Many scholars are discussing this issue in Muslim world. And of course, as you know, Muslim people have a lot of children. And because they believe that God gave them life, and we have to keep this life. And generally, abortions are not performed. However, they have situations that they are legalized, like rape, of mother or incest. Let me read you one thing which the famous Imam As-Hayafi writes in his letter to Dur al-Mukhtar. Aborting the pregnancy will be permissible due to valid reason provided the soul has not yet entered the fetus. Which means they sort of legalize their sin, because they still claim that it's a big sin to abort baby before 4 months, but after is a huge sin and is a murder to do it. So Muslims are very fragile, stand on this position. But still, as I said, they have a loophole saying that in case of rape, incest, and the health of mother, abortion can be performed. So generally, this is what people think about. Very interesting, Jehovah's Witnesses, which is considered to be a cult, they still believe that Jesus conceived, that the baby is conceived at the time of conception, and abortion is totally forbidden. Mormons say the same, however, as certain loopholes related to health of mother and the situation with fetus. For example, in Asia, let's go back now to some figures and countries. In Asia, it was performed about 26 million abortions. The leader, of course, is China. China is really a horror story, especially during the Mao Zedong revolution. I never traveled to China under Mao Zedong, but I went to China just after it became openness in the 90s, early 90s. And I can tell you, I didn't believe this, what I saw. During 40 years of China ruling, the Maoist ruling, and the communists after Mao Zedong, they killed almost 380 million children. 380 million children. Because it was one child policy, okay? You could have only one baby. Recently, 2 months ago, Chinese government lifted this restriction, so now you can have more babies in China, thank God. But this is what happened in China. Currently, China is performing about last 14 is about 26, 27 million abortions still going in China. If more Chinese women will have access, because only 1.2% have access to one day pills, it's expensive, the rate will go up. Obviously, it's a secret rate, but the official rate will go up. Australia has a very strange law too. Some provinces are forbidding having abortion. Some are legalized and open. It's state to state depends. They performed about 90,000 abortions 2 years ago. Very interesting is African continent. Africa, as you know, is a mixture of Muslim, Christians, and if you look at the map of Africa, what you see, all Muslim countries, the abortions are very low, relatively low. And abortions are not very popular in Africa due to probably many things, money and resources. But still women are against abortions in general. Also women are against artificial feeding newborns with breastfeeding. And the history time show that they've been right. Okay. In Africa they perform about 5.6 million abortions a year. They are performing about. The worst is South Africa. In South Africa everybody can have abortion. So South Africa is very open. But other countries are very restricted, as I said, depends on the Christians or Muslims. But they really relatively look continent of Africa, which has about 400 million people, it's relatively low percentage. We don't know what will happen if the one-day pill will be introduced to Africa. We don't know. It will happen, probably will happen in the next 10 years or 15 years, because it's still very expensive. Latin America. Latin America is really as a huge continent. South America, of course, including Mexico, Brazil, the largest population. So I give you an example of Brazil, who is the largest. They perform 1.4 million abortions. And only, it's totally banned, except one thing, rape. So every woman can go and say, I was raped. She will have abortion with many problems. But if she will try to do because economical reasons, I am a teenager, no abortions, period. So Brazil is very strict. However, many illegal abortions perform, of course, in the countryside. Mexico generally has ban on abortions, only has to be rape, incest, or fetus has to be severely damaged. So legally, they have medical abortion, 75,000. But they estimate about 500,000 women have abortions illegally. Very interesting is Cuba. Why I think Cuba? Because Cuba now will have the openness. And in Cuba, abortion is the worst. This is the worst country in the Western Hemisphere. It's so bad that Fidel Castro, in 2005, I think, or 6, asked Catholic Church for help. Because abortion would be just 65% pregnancy aborted. 65%. So the reason why, because demographic in Cuba will be going down, so nobody wants to have a baby because they hardship, of course. And abortion was performed just free of charge everywhere. And still is, but I have hope, and we have hope, let's pray for Cubans, great people, that they will stop. Cuba performed only, generally 85,000 a year, but Cuba is a very small country. But they had 140,000 pregnancies a year, so not reason they want the bill. And I think younger generation is more educated now, became more educated than being 10, 15 years ago. I believe personally that education and prevention is the only one thing that we can win. Because whenever I traveled, Romania, I saw the HIV children dying. I have seen everything, what you can imagine. I've been in Haiti 2 years ago, which is end of the world. If you like to see end of the world, go to Haiti and you'll cry all day. I've been in the Dominican Republic, Father. And Latin America is against abortion in general. In Nicaragua, Honduras, they are banned 100%, Chile banned only certain cases, but it's illegal to have abortion. But the United States has 1.3 million abortions a year. If we will introduce education to our classes, to CBC classes, in our Catholic Church classes, I think 1 hour class or 2 hours per whole semester, I think it will open young people what can be done to prevent abortion. Because abortion is really very traumatic for women. Sooner or later, it will come and haunt the person. Because we have soul and we have consciousness. Canada, the last to say, is against abortion. However, it's still very easy to have abortion in Canada. From 1970 to 2010, they performed 3.2 million abortions in Canada. Currently, on average, it's about 65,000 abortions per year in Canada. It's much easier to have abortion in Canada than in the United States. So, in summary, because my time is past now, I think we should talk to our grandchildren and children that are many ways to prevent abortion. And education is the future for us, humanity, to survive this horror story which is going all over the world. Thank you very much. I would like to have a questions, and we will, Ron will give you microphones so everybody can hear. So please feel free to ask me anything you want.
So if you have a question, please raise your hand. I'll bring the mic over to you and we'd love to hear it.
Here.
Dr. Seidel, you mentioned the number of surgical abortions have gone down, but the morning after pill, are there any statistics or any findings about any women health issues by taking this pill?
Not really, no data available. The companies companies are selling the drugs, we're not going to release this data. You're talking about side effects, you think?
Yes, side effects.
Not really data available yet. As I know, I have to look into this, but as I know, generally it's very safe. I talked to several patients who take this in Europe. They told me it was fine. I don't feel any side effects. So, but I didn't follow it precisely. Deacon?
What is the percentage of abortions in the United States?
One day pill. Contraceptive or one day pill?
Well, I was thinking of the formal abortions. What fraction of babies are aborted in the United States?
Well, I mean, fraction, what do you mean? I mean, 1.4 to 3 million we have per year abortions in the United States.
How many births?
Sorry?
How many births? Live births.
Live births?
Yeah. What fraction is being aborted?
Unfortunately, I believe it's the ratio, unfortunately, is 5 to 1.
Actually, that question would be very difficult to answer. answer, because there are actually four states, New Hampshire being one of them, that don't even report the abortions. Okay, 2 years ago we tried to pass a law that would force us to report it and got shut down. And California is one of those others, and of course, they don't have a lot of money, so we can't answer that question. So.
Actually, yes.
This is Michael's son, Alexander Spidell. Unfortunately, the ratio may be as high as 1 to 1. One abortion for every 1 live birth. It fluctuates. It could be 1 to 2, one abortion for every 2 live births, or 1 to 1, depending on how you calculate it. I think my father has been trying to explain that the so-called morning after pill has a statistical problem associated with, insofar as it's not distributed through abortion clinics. It's often dispensed through ordinary family physicians, paraclinics, places like urgent care centers. So there may be a great many children that lose their lives due to a technology that is very hard to trace and is not as statistically carefully measured as the so-called, I hate to call it traditional, but the so-called surgical abortion. I think as a society in general, many, many young women feel the need to take the morning after pill no matter what, if they have any doubt as to whether their contraceptive technology failed. So, it's becoming increasingly difficult to gauge, but I've heard estimates ranging from 1 to 1 to 1 to 2. So, thank you.
Yes, please understand that it's extremely difficult to pinpoint the numbers yet. Probably sooner we have more data available from state to state, it could be monitored much more carefully, like what Alex is right concerning. It's probably 1 to 1 or even higher. Yes.
Since the rate of contraception is extremely high, okay, where I hear you can go into the 80%, 90%, and sometimes over, but certainly high. Is there any concern on the people, like these doctors, to make sure that contraception is dealt with? Because a woman on the pill can abort 2 or 3 times a year. So if that is the case, there are probably more abortions through contraception than surgical.
Very difficult question. To answer, please understand that doctors understand, since introduction I was, by the way, in Medical College of Georgia, where the pill was, the pills being introduced in the 60s, they've been discovered by one of the gynecologists in Medical College of Georgia. Generally, we know that a woman who is taking anticonception pills every day is a high risk for probably breast cancer, probably for some miscarriages, but still very hard to pinpoint this data. As you said, doctors realize, well, yes and no. I mean, if you have a patient who in the United States coming to your office and asking for a prescription, you cannot refuse because of the law. You can refuse to practice in a certain clinic, obviously. But if we are aware about that, yes, I am aware, most colleagues, yes, they are too. But to say that this is the truth, I don't know, it's hard to say.
Different per country, what they do, or they just throw them up in the trash?
please understand that if you have a first trimester abortion, generally this tissue is so small that it's sucked by the suction, using suction, then it disposes and burns in incinerators. That's a hospital procedure. If you have a baby which has been stillborn or aborted, like you think, they abort huge babies. They really don't do that in the United States. They do in other countries, okay? Here they don't do it. I mean, if baby is in distress or is a dead fetus, they do cesarean section and they just take the fetus and they burn it. Especially incinerators and clinic hospitals. I work as a student and I had all limbs also burned down. So I fed the incinerator with limbs. Our organs. We don't turn them to the garbage, and that's the procedure. I heard horror stories that people found in Concord on a recycling bin, the trash with some tissues. That's really, it's high risk tissue also, because we're talking HIV, we're talking hepatitis, so they should be disposed correctly. That's what we do, we burn them down. In other countries, they burn them down also. Or they have also funerals, like we do. Small babies, you get body, and I assisted many patients with the body I gave to families, and they have a funeral. I don't know if you understand one thing, maybe you don't, maybe you heard. Under the law, a fetus, which is smaller than 500 grams in the United States, also as global law, is not considered to be a human. I mean, human. Yes, it is human, but it's not considered a name because it's not for the variety of purposes. People could claim that he's my. I can write a will that this baby is going to be my. Get my money or possessions. So if beyond 500 grams is cut off, the person does not get a name. You cannot call him John Smith, you can call him Johnny or something, but he cannot get a name, or she cannot get a name. This is the law. I don't know if you heard about that, but that's funny, but this is the law.
Dr. Smith-Dama, what is your opinion on when a fetus is pain capable when that happens? Is there medical science in agreement on that? And how do doctors rationalize that more readily perform abortions?
You have two very important questions. First question, yes, of course, the baby feels. Because the neurotic system, neurons, the brain is formed generally in the first 6 weeks. If you look, also circulation and hardness is created also in the 8 weeks, if I remember correctly. It depends, it's very close, very fast development of fetus. If you like, I'd be happy to show you a movie about development of fetus. Very interesting. Of course, it's the same question. You catch the fish. The fish is suffering if you kill her, of course. People think now, yes, it does. People thought before they don't. They didn't. Yes, they do suffer, of course, silently. And your second question was if doctors realize about that?
How they rationalize. Like, doctors, a lot of doctors are very careful with their patients that they want to make sure they're not in any pain and really sensitive to that. How do they rationalize performing on abortions on fetuses that they know can feel what they're doing?
You cannot talk to patients about that. It would be more trauma for mothers. Because mother during abortion, I mean, every woman doesn't make abortion. If you show me a woman who will say, oh, it's great, I will not believe you. I can tell you one thing. I have seen patients which may have 4, 5, 6 abortions before they get married. And every time they had that, because social economical situation, it was a shame to have a baby in the countryside. Sooner or later, in their contexts, where atheists may remember it. And we will have a very nice presentation. I invite you in April, Jill Matuszewski from our parish in London, there will have a great presentation of trauma of abortion for women. This is something a lot of women should hear, and also men should hear. Because mainly abortion is because boyfriend doesn't want a baby. I'm not ready yet to be married and say he's forcing her to have abortion. Otherwise, women wouldn't like to have abortion. It's not pleasant to go to the whole process. And the procedure is relatively fast, but it's painful, and it's also traumatic for women, very traumatic. So if you tell them extra, well, your baby's now suffering, you should cry. I mean, believe me, you can kill a patient. I mean, kill. Psychologically, you can make tremendous trauma to patient. So no, you cannot tell like that.
Well, I think that the question was how these abortion providers justify their actions.
I have a colleague who went for my abortions, and how they justify, well, it's like justify my existence by buying bigger cars and bigger houses, because I may perform abortions for them. It's a nice next procedure to do. Next procedure. Do they feel guilt? I think yes, if they became older. I have a colleague in Poland who performed abortions. And he told me that he stopped doing that about 15 years ago. He's now my age. And he regrets what he was doing. Some do, some don't, of course. Some have no conscience. Some people have no conscience. It's like asking if what the murderer thought about that, did he have feelings about killing somebody? You know, some people have no conscience. So they feel fine. They can't even drink after that. I'm sorry to say that I'm telling you the truth. People with conscience don't perform abortions, period. I was an example. I didn't. Please, no questions, ask me anything.
I think you mentioned education as one of the big ways to affect the abortion catastrophe. Could you speak a little more about kinds of education and where it should take place?
Very good question. However, forgive me if I'm going to be too honest. I propose now, church, that our CDC classes will come here and listen to these lectures. I promise that I will not show any tragic, dramatic movies or pictures, because I understand it can be some girls, teenagers, very traumatic. But I would like to talk about this more openly and have one class, 1 hour, such presentation, one or two, for this young woman and young men to tell them the truth. Because if we are politically correct, and we are, it's going nowhere, because children sooner or later will get this information from Google. They will get information from more experienced girls or boyfriends or whatever. And sooner or later, they will be confused, lost, because they don't have a trust. If parents don't talk to children about that, they lose trust. With a young girl, where she will go and ask for help? Of course, mother. But mother is too busy. Mother doesn't want to talk about that. My parents didn't talk to me as well. We didn't have an education in Poland. We're talking 60s, 70s. We didn't have it in high schools. It was forbidden to teach about reproduction biology. So, but we are in America. We should go ahead and give example to the world. My brother lives in Austria, Vienna. They don't have sex classes. Really, they don't. I was teaching students here, and they don't know anything about